For the Athletic Awards, we're going to start off with the Sally Bullard Award. This is awarded annually to a 6th grade student athlete for whom respect for others is a way of life, who has an unfailing regard for opponents as well as teammates, and who participates in sports for the love of it, to the sound of cheering from within. This year's recipient of the Girls Sally Bullard Award is Lucy Parker, and I'm going to turn this over to Coach Carpenter so she can talk a little bit more about Lucy.
The 6th grade sports award goes to Lucy Parker for her constant enthusiasm, drive, and dedication to Pike sports. Lucy was a player you could ask to play any position in any sport, and she would always give you an enthusiastic, yes, of course. In field hockey, she was asked to play defense, and her response was, sure, I'll try that. I've never played before, but okay. And then she went out and became an anchor on the defense. On the ice, Lucy was always the smallest one out there, and she went into the corners as if she was someone 3, 4, 5 times her size. Against a Phillips Andover team filled with juniors and seniors in high school, we tried Lucy on forward, but we quickly realized we had nothing to worry about with her on defense because she was fearless, confident, and willing to take on older girls for the betterment of her team. Lucy was always the first one to practice and the last one to leave, using every extra moment to practice her shot and improve her game. Her smile, positive attitude, and tenacity are unmatched, and we're fortunate to have her as a Pike student athlete for years to come. Congratulations, Lucy.
This year's recipient of the Boys Sally Bullard Award is Izzy Wayne, and I'm going to turn this over to Coach Kelly so he can talk a little bit more about Izzy.
I had the pleasure of coaching Izzy Wayne this winter with the JV boys basketball team. I think what initially stuck out to me and what impressed me about Izzy was his skill as an athlete, but also his competitiveness. But the longer the season went on, the more time I spent with him, I was even more impressed by so many other characteristics that he had as an athlete. Even though he was the only 6th grader on our team, he showed incredible leadership. He really separated himself early from a skill standpoint, but was always looking for ways to help teammates grow and get better. He was more concerned about being a good teammate than his own individual accomplishments, which makes him the perfect recipient for the Sally Bullard Award. It was such a joy to get to coach Izzy and watch him grow as an athlete and a leader in just one season. And I can't wait to see what the rest of his career at Pike looks like.
The next award is the John Hopkins Award. This is awarded to the 7th grade student athlete who has shown extremely high commitment to Pike athletics and who has been the ultimate team player. This year's recipient of the Boys John Hopkins Award is Jackson McDonald. And I'm going to turn this back over to Coach Kelly so he can talk a little bit more about Jackson.
Jackson McDonald is a very worthy recipient of the John Hopkins Award. I had the opportunity to both watch and coach Jackson this year. Before I coached Jackson, I got to see his tenacity and relentless motor on the soccer field. And talking to other coaches who had had him, everybody would talk about his coachability and consistency. And I got to witness that firsthand in the winter during the intramural basketball program. What impressed me the most was in that scenario where we weren't playing in front of a lot of people or traveling to different schools to play in big games, he still showed up to practice every day, ready to learn, and competed as hard as ever. And to have him set the tone for our program was so meaningful and important and just contagious to all the other athletes in the gym. So congratulations to Jackson on this well-deserved award, and I look forward to your continued commitment to Pike Athletics.
The recipient of this year's Girls John Hopkins Award is Lauren Tucker. I had the privilege of coaching Lauren this past soccer season. As a 7th grader, Lauren is one of the best all-around players on the field, but what I was most impressed with was how she made everyone around her better. The truly gifted athletes not only good individually, but also elevate their teammates around them. And that's exactly what Lauren did all season. She's a player with a ton of skill, but is one of the most unselfish players you will see. She led by example during practices and games as she always gave unbelievable effort. Lauren plays the game with no fear and is willing to do whatever she can do to help the team be successful. She really is the ultimate team player. It was an honor to coach her this year. Congratulations, Lauren.
The Boys Athletic Award is given to the 8th or 9th grade student athlete who exemplifies outstanding sportsmanship. I'm thrilled to announce that the recipient of this year's award is Dylan Leonard. I've had the real joy of being able to coach Dylan in hockey the last 4 years, and he is a joy to have on the team. He's always looking out for the other players, particularly the younger ones, who he made feel at home as they were learning the ropes as part of our program. He was also that rare student who was willing to give up a shift or two of his own to give the less experienced players more opportunities to play in our games. Pike hockey was more fun for all of us because Dylan Leonard had such a positive attitude and was so willing to support his teammates. Congratulations, Dylan.
The Girls Athletic Award is awarded to the 8th or 9th grade student athlete exemplifying outstanding sportsmanship. This year's recipient of the Girls Athletic Award is Angelina Natale. I'm going to hand it over to Coach Cardello to talk a little bit more about Angelina.
Congratulations, Angelina, on your award. It was a pleasure to coach you this fall during our field hockey season. I knew at every practice you would give 110%. At games, you were always willing to work hard and improve your game, and you always were extremely coachable. Wish you all the best on your graduation. Congratulations, and good luck in your high school career.
The last award is the Carrie Cater Award. This is awarded annually to the 8th or 9th grade students who best exemplify Carrie's athletic ability and personal characteristics. Always involved with sports, enthusiasm, assertiveness, and meeting the athletic challenge posed by both opponents and team competition. This year's recipient of the Boys Carrie Cater Award is JZL Polanco. I've had the privilege of coaching JZL for the last 3 years in basketball and 2 years in soccer. The transformation I've seen him make from a 7th grader to a 9th grader has been amazing, not only as a player, but as a person and a leader. This past season, JZL led us on the court and off the court. He led by example every day. When your best player is one of the hardest workers in practice and is one of the first ones in the gym and last ones to leave, it sets the tone for the rest of the team and makes the coach's job a lot easier. He consistently wanted to get better every day and always asked questions. He always wanted feedback after every game and advice on what he could do better. JZL had a great career at Pike and has left his mark on the basketball program as the team went 38-4 during his 3 years on the team. Thank you for all your hard work and dedication, and thank you for putting your trust in me and always being coachable. I look forward to watching you accomplish more at the next level. Congrats, Jazzy. This year's recipient of the Girls Carrie Cater Award are Avery Taylor and Ellie Parker. And I'm gonna actually turn this over to SportsCenter, and they're gonna talk a little bit more about these two amazing athletes.
Well, today we are highlighting the Pike Schools Award winners for the Carrie Cater Award.
Ah, that's a big one. I like that one.
Oh, you're not kidding, Boston. Sure is. These two athletes are so extraordinary that they both needed to be recognized for this big award.
All right. Well, let's see who we got here. All right. So let's start with this Avery Taylor kid. What do you know about her?
Oh, yeah. Avery, my goodness. First of all, I mean, she has to be one of the toughest athletes I have ever coached. She's a three-sport superstar, basically. She's made her mark as a three-year starter for Pike Varsity Women's Soccer, Ice Hockey, and Lacrosse. Standout in all three.
Wow. Did you coach her for those?
Oh, yes. I did have the privilege of coaching Avery almost every season.
Hmm. Do you have one particular moment that was the most memorable for you?
Well, you know, there's so many moments I could pick, but I think the one that really stands out for me is this past season in a hockey game, Avery just went nuts. She had over 20 shots in the opening period.
What?
I know. It's just crazy. That'd be like a team total for a game. Yeah. What? She was just fighting off everyone, going crazy. Her tenacity as an athlete is just unsurpassed. She's one of those rare players. She can pick an entire team up, put them on her back, and carry them right on to victory. She's extraordinary.
Wow. That's crazy.
Wow, yeah. But how about our other winner? How about this Ellie Parker? I hear you've coached her at Pike.
Oh, yeah, this Parker kid. So first taught her in math in sixth grade. Then I coached her in lacrosse. Everybody knows what that means.
And then, you kept the stats and the time, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yep, you know what? You got to be good at something, right? Then I coached her at field hockey this past year.
All right, so let's talk about Ellie. What can you tell us about her?
This kid has so much passion. She's so motivated when it comes to everything she does, and it's especially evident on the field. As soon as I saw her pick up a lacrosse stick, I was just like, who knew you could do that with that thing? I remember just watching her do, you know, the thing where they raise the stick up and down, they go like this and like this. Yeah.
Cradling.
Cradling. Okay. So you couldn't even see the ball. You could see her just bobbing and weaving through players, and then all of a sudden the ball would be flying over the goalie's shoulder into the back of the net. And I was like, I didn't see that. That's at the speed of lightning.
Wow. Wow. Impressive. And what about field hockey? I hear she's quite a goalie.
Yeah, you know, sports she just picked up over the summer and then went to nationals this year. Kid's so athletic, lives and breathes it. She's so encouraging. Even if you're down in the game, she'll make something happen to get you back in. And she's going to keep the spirits up. Whatever the team needs, she's willing and excited to do it.
Yeah, you know, I have to agree with that, because having coached her in ice hockey, those exploits are pretty legendary. She actually had 44 saves in the goal against the Brooks team this year. Really, really kept the squad in the game. You know, rumor has it that she was seen actually physically standing on her head during that game.
I believe it. I believe it.
Yep.
These two have had such great careers. It's crazy.
Yep. They sure have. And I really can't wait to follow both of their exploits in secondary school and beyond.
I can't wait for that either. Well, congratulations, Avery and Ellie, on two amazing careers at Pike. Pike will sure miss you. Not only your talent, but your leadership on and off the field. Back to you in the studio.